Today we are going to discuss the rumen fermentation and stomach digestion. We have discussed the anatomy and physiology of the digestive system, but today specifically we are discussing the anatomy and histology of the ruminant stomach and as well as the simple stomach. The ruminant having a four compartments, the rumen, reticulum, omasum, and having a rumen, reticulum, the omasum, and abomasum. Histomorphology, the rumen having papillae, and then and these papillae are responsible in giving the digestion and absorption to the food atoms. The ruminants born with a non-functioning rumen and needs to develop anatomically and physiologically. Development depends upon diet types fed the young pre-ruminant animals. The reticulum in a newborn is 5%, and at the age of 2 to 3 months, it remains a 5%. And even when they are adults, the reticulum does not change its size. But the rumen in the newborn, it is a 25% of the compound or a four stomach animal having four compartments, whereas at the age of 2 to 3 months, the rumen changes its size, takes a capacity of 65%, and at the age of an adult, it moves up to 80% of the total compartment or total compound stomach. Omasum at the in the newborn, it's a 10%. At the age of 2 to 3 months, it remains the same size, which is of a 10% of a total stomach, whereas it is in the adult age, it reduces up to 7-8%. Whereas in the newborn, the abomasum is 60%, which reduces its size at the age of 2 to 3 months. That is a 20% of the compound stomach. And at the age of adult, it reduces up to 7-8%. So the rumen papillae, rumen interior surface contains fibers like papillae, vary in shape and size from short and pointed to a long foliate. Papillae length is in a cow, it is a 10 to 15 mm, whereas in a young sheep, it is 3.4 to 4.6 mm, and in a young goat it is 4 to 6 mm. The rumen epithelium, the rumen wall including a papillae, squamous keratinized stratified cells, provides a barrier between the blood and liminal environment of a rumen, a max up of 40 to 60% of a total rumen weight, and influenced by the nature of a diet and volatile fatty acids to which they are exposed. A rumen, the world's largest commercial fermentation space, 100 billion liters of a rumen volume in domestic animals, 10 raised by 10 or 10 raised by 12 cells per ml. Rumen capacity ranges from less than 1 liter, there's one quart and decurs, and to 200 liters, which is about 50 gallons, and a cow. The ruminant having a continuous culture fermenters, input and output, lignocellulosic substrates like forages, digested cellulase complex or hemicelluloses, the nitrogen capture, and it into 10^15 mouse to feed. Because of the microbial enzymes, ruminants can utilize feedstuffs that provides a little to no nutritional benefits to non-ruminants. There are four steps of a rumination. One is the regurgitation. Otherwise, the peristaltic carries the food to mouth. Then remastication, a liquid is squeezed from bolus and swallowed, bolus chewed. The re-salivation, adding more saliva, then re-deglutition, swelling of a bolus and liquids into the stomach. And inside, look that the animal eats food from a mouth, it goes to the esophagus and then it is reached in the rumen, and then the cut of the rumen is regurgitated in the mouth to digest the food, and then it goes to the reticulum and then omasum, abomasum, small intestine, which is consists of a duodenum, ileum, duodenum, and then the large intestine having a cecum, a colon, and a rectum, then the exit through anus. You can see this video where the animal regurgitate by taking the food. This is a female which is a pseudo ruminant. It takes food into the mouth and then it regurgitate for making it more digestible, and then it swallows again. So this is the regurgitation having a four steps, as the mastication, then regurgitation has a regurgitation, and then the mastication, and then the swallowing takes place in the animals, in the buffalo and cow, goat and sheep. Mostly the regurgitation may take place after eating food, and when they are resting, then the animal regurgitate normally. So allow the animal to forages and eat a food rapidly, and then store for a later digestion. Reduces the particle size. Only a small particle leaves the reticulorumen. Increases surface area for a microbial attachment and digestion fermentation. Breaks down the imperious plant walls, and further stimulation of the saliva flows. The saliva serves to buffer the rumen. So rumination time, average time for a grazing animal is eating 8 hours, ruminating 8 hours, and resting 8 hours. So the ruminating time is quite a variable. High variation, reducing of forage is concentrate decreases the remuneration. So reducing a particle size of forage decreases the time spent ruminant. So mechanism of elimination is regurgitation. Stimulus digest of fibers made the scratching surface near the cardiac sphincter. Then the contraction of the reticulum forces the digester to a cardia. Animal inhales with the epiglottis closed to produce a vacuum. Cardiac sphincter opens and esophagus dilates, and negative pressure vacuum sucks the digester into the esophagus. A rapid reverse peristaltic moves the digester to mouth. Bolus is a re-chewed. The chewing is slower and more deliberate than during initial eating phase. Digester re-salivated. The parotid gland secretes more saliva during the rumination than eating, and saliva from parotid gland secretes more sodium bicarbonate than other glands. Re-swallowing. After re-swallowing, the rumen contracts to move swallowed bolus into the rumen. Mostly the cud are chewed and saliva is added. The cud from the front layers are erected, whereas the cuds placed at a rear part of the rumen, small particles gradually sink. So the remastication and reglutination takes place in the animals when they are regurgitating. So the chewing during eating, minimal preparation of a swelling, release the soluble constituents, damage the plant tissues for a microbial attachment. Then the chewing during remastication extensive, so decreases the particle size for passage and damage plant tissues for a microbial attachment. Microbial digestion takes place by reticulo-ruminal contraction. The rumen contraction inoculates incoming feed with microbes and mix the contents, minimize the effect of a satisfactory stratification, moves the fermentation products, volatile fatty acids, to a rumen wall. Particles, sorting and passage of small particles to omasum, then rumination, the eructation of fermentation gases. This is the ruminoreticulomotilities, which takes place in the animals to break down the larger particles into the smaller and then pass away the food contents to the reticulum, rumen to a reticulum. This needs eructation. The composition of rumen gases is carbon dioxide is 65.35%. The methane gas is 27.76%. The nitrogen is 7%. Oxygen is 0.56%. Hydrogen is 0.18%. Sulfuric acid is 0.01%. So the peak gas production occurs at 30 minutes to 2 hours post-feeding, 30 to 50 liters per hour in cow and 5 liters per hour in sheep and goats. Approximately 30% of carbon dioxide produced in the rumen is absorbed into the blood and removed through the lungs. Remainder is erected. Only 20% of the methane is removed through the lungs, 80% is eructated. Control of eructation takes place by the stimulus, the gaseous distension of the reticulum and the rumen, esophagus dilates and the animal belches, 12 to 30 liters per minute for cattle, and 3 to 17 times per minute. The inhibition the presence of a digester near the cardiac sphincter affects the all three sphincters and protective mechanism to prevent the digester from entering the lungs. So it's epinephrine light or flight response takes place. The inhibition of eructation will cause the animal to bloat. So ruminal pressure will increase up to 100 mmHg. So stable froth or foam formed in the rumen. Feed the microbes, let the microbes feed the ruminant. So the feed in the volatile fatty acids, microbial protein, vitamins. So the nutrients presented to the animal after ruminal fermentations are very different than those entering the rumen as fed. The rumen digestion and fermentation takes place by a degradation of a feed. The rumen microbes degrade the food and produces the carbon dioxide, volatile fatty acids, microbial cells, ammonia, methane, heat, long chain fatty acids, and sulfuric acids. So products in a red are used by the host animals, whereas the products listed in a black and green are not usable by the animals, whereas the products listed in a green are the primary energy losses from the rumen. Location of a microbes, that's a rumen wall. Then the gas phase is at the upper side. Fiber mat is in the mid, and the rumen fillet is in the bottom. The rumen reticulum motilities also having the gases at the upper side, and today's hay in the middle, and the grain and the yesterday's hay is in the bottom. So the rumen microorganisms are nutritional requirements, the carbon dioxide, energy, the end products from a digestion of a structural carbohydrates, fermentation of a sugars, the nitrogen, the ammonia, a majority of the nitrogen needs, the amino acids, cellulitic bacteria, and the minerals, the cobalt, sulfur, phosphorus, sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, manganese, ferrous, zinc, selenium, and molybdenum. The vitamins non-required in mixed cultures of a bacteria. The symbiotic relationship microbes provides to the ruminants. The digestion of a cellulose and hemicellulose. Proviance of a high quality protein. Production of a volatile fatty acids. Proviance of B vitamins. And detoxification of a toxic compounds. The digestion of a cellulose and a hemicellulose, the cellulases are all of a microbial origin. Without microbes, ruminants would not been able to use forage crops such as a pasture, hay, or silage. So provision of a high quality protein, 50 to 80% of a absorbed nitrogen is from microbes. Improved microbial efficiency will provide a more microbial protein. Can get over a 3 kg of a microbial protein per day in cattle. High biological value protein source is amino acid pattern. Is very similar to that required for ruminal animals. So the microbes as a feed source, bacteria and protozoa washed out of the rumen to a omism and into the abomism. Acidic environment kills the microorganisms, digested and absorbed the same as any other feed source in stomach and small intestine, provide amino acids and some energy. सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी लिविंग ह्यूमन वोलेटाइल फैटी एसिड 70%, माइक्रोबियल सेल्स प्रोड्यूस 10% एंड डाइजेस्टिबल अनफर्मेंटेड फीड 20%. The non-glucose available for the ruminants is concentration of volatile fatty acids in a rumen that is a 50 to 120 micromole per ml. The provision of B vitamins is meets the ruminants requirements under most conditions. Some supplementation of a specific vitamins such as niacin, vitamin B3 may be beneficial in early lactation for dairy cows. Detoxification of toxic compounds. Many potential toxins are detoxified by rumen microbes. Mimosine in Lucina causes a problems, a poor growth, reproduction, and hair fall. Some ruminants have microbes that degrade the mimosine, so the Lucina could be failed. The ruminants provide the microbes housing, garbage removal, nutrients, and optimal environment for growth. Housing, reliable heat is available, that is 939 centigrade in a ruminants. Fluid environment requires free water intake, that is 85 to 90% of water is available in a rumen, whereas guaranteed housing for 18 to 96 hours in a rumen, depending on the diet and type of animals. Extra fed water for buffalo, longest rumen residence time for a microbes. Small selective browsers, mouse, deer, duiker. The duiker is a antelope, the deers, the shortest residence time for microbes. Garbage removal. The absorption of volatile fatty acids, energy to a ruminant, eruption of carbon dioxide and methane gas, the passage of indigestible residue and microbes to a lower gastrointestinal tract, rumen mixing to a separate and settle the small particles. The nutrients. So substrates come from feed stuffs that animal consumes. Saliva provides a urea, nitrogen source for the bacteria. Optimal environment for growth of the microorganisms. Reduce the environment little to no oxygen. So the strict and aerobic microbes in rumen interior. Facultative anaerobes near the rumen wall. pH is 6 to 7. The saliva contains the bicarbonate and phosphate buffers, and cow produces up to 50 gallons of saliva daily and continuously secreted. So more added during the eating and rumination. Cow ruminates 10 to 12 hours per day, decreases in the particle size of forages, reduces need for rumination, and decreases the chewing time and decrease the saliva production and rumen pH polymers. So the salivary glands are present, which is producing the saliva, and the roughages provides up to 150 liters, and the grain and concentrate provides the liquid up to 40 liters. So the optimal environment of a pH, if the pH is 5.7 rather than 6.5, 50% is a less microbial synthesis, and the cellulitic bacteria functions best at the pH of 6.8. The rate of structural carbohydrates use is decreased. So amylolytic bacteria functions best at the pH of 5.8. more lactate and less acetate is produced, so further downward the pH spiral. In concentrated selectors like deer, parotid salivary glands are 0.3% of a body weight. Symbiotic relationship is the microbes provides to the ruminant digestion of a cellulose or hemicellulose, provision of a high quality protein, production of a volatile fatty acids, provision of a B vitamins, and detoxification of a toxic compounds. The ruminants provides to a microbes housing, garbage removal, nutrients, and optimal environment for growth. The microbes, the bacteria is 60 to 90% of a mass. The generation interval is 20 minutes, whereas the 25 to 80 billion per ml is produced in the rumen. Protozoa is 10 to 40% of a mass. That generation interval is 8 to 36 hours, and the 200 to 500 thousands per ml protozoa is present in the rumen. The fungi is 5 to 10% of the mass, so it takes a 24 hours in generation interval, and that has a minimum number per ml. Rumen microbes, the bacteria is more than 200 species, with many subspecies, 25 species at a concentrations, and that is more than 10 raised 7 by ml. So 10 raised by 10 to 12, 10 raised by 12 cells per ml are present in the rumen, whereas 99.5% obligate anaerobes are present in the rumen. The environmental niches for a bacteria is the groups of a bacteria in the rumen, free living in the liquid phase, loosely associated with the feed particles, firmly adhered to the feed particles, and associated with the rumen epithelium attached to the surface of a protozoa and fungi as well. The benefits of bacterial attachment is that allows the bacteria to colonize the digestible surface of a feed particles, brings the enzymes from a microbes and subtracts from the feed strips together, protect the microbial enzymes from proteases in the rumen. If the attachment prevented or reduced, digestion of a cellulose greatly reduced. Retention time of a microbes in the rumen is increased to prolong the digestion. Reduces the predatory activity of a protozoa. Overfeeding fed to a ruminants can coat the forages, reduces the bacterial attachment. The microbial population is cellulitic bacteria fiber digesters, digest the cellulose and hemicellulose, requires a pH 6 to 7 and utilize the nitrogen in form of a ammonia, requires a sulfur for synthesis of a sulfur containing amino acids, cysteine and methionine, produce acetate, propionate, a little butyrate, carbon dioxide, and predominant in a rumen of a cow's feed roughages diets. Microbial population, amylolytic bacteria digest the starches and sugars, requires 5 to 6 pH, and utilize the nitrogen as a ammonia or a peptides, produces a propionate, butyrate, and lactate, predominant in the rumens of a cow's fed grain diets. A rapid change to a grain diet causes a lactic acidosis, so rapidly decreases the pH. Methane produced the bacteria, produce the methane utilized by microbes for energy, represent a loss of energy to animal and released by eructation. Protozoa, that's a large 20 to 200 microns unicellular organism, ingest the bacteria and feed the particles, engulf the feed particles and digest. carbohydrate, protein, and fats. Numbers affected by diet. So this is the Entodenium Riemann protozoa. Riemann microbes, the fungi exist is known for about 25 years, and numbers usually low. Digest the recalcitrant fibers. The dietary factors that reduce the microbial growth is rapid, dramatic ration changes. Takes 3 to 4 weeks for microbes to stabilize. Restricted amounts of feed, excessive unsaturated fat. Bacteria do not use the fat for energy. Enables the fiber digestion and microbial growth. Different types of fat have a different effects. So the dietary factors that reduces the microbial growth, excessive non-structural carbohydrates, a lower Riemann pH, Riemann acidosis, so salad the feeding, feed barley or wheat rapidly fermented. To prevent the acidosis, must balance the lactase users and producers. The dietary factors that maximize the microbial growth, that's the maximum dry matter intake, the balanced carbohydrate and protein fractions at the same time. Bacteria need both energy and nitrogen for amino acid synthesis. Gradual ration changes, feed available at all times, maintain a stable Riemann pH. So the Riemann pH, the frequent feeding are TMR twice a day, the time. The digestion and the utilization of a protein. The diet is feeded, the protein goes into the degradation in the Riemann, and that it produces the ammonia, and it is non-proteinous nitrogen also produces the ammonia, and as well as the urea also gives back the ammonia to the Riemann. Degradation takes place, and then it is passes to the protein is passes to the ribosome, and then it is converted into the amino acids, and then the amino acids goes to the liver to be utilized for the development of the tissues and as well as production of the urea, and also it is also to produce the milk in the animals. The undigestible proteins also excreted through a feces. Whereas the digestion and the utilization of carbohydrate, the carbohydrates are degraded and digested into volatile fatty acids, that's producing acetic acid, propionate, butyric, which is absorbed directly into the bloodstream, whereas that produce a carbon dioxide and methane gas, which is excreted, and then the undigested carbohydrates goes into the ribosome and intestine, where it is converted into the sugars and then absorbed into the blood. And undigested carbohydrate is excreted through a feces. Whereas the digestion of and the utilization of fats, the saturated fat and unsaturated fat is in the Riemann, that is converted into a saturated fat, and then it is go into the ribosome, where the saturated fat is absorbed through the blood, and then it goes to the body tissues for a metabolism. And undigested fat is excreted through a feces. This is the structure that the Riemann microbes that is digesting the carbohydrates into a acetate, propionate, and butyrate. And then it is the presence of a acetylco enzyme A that is producing the carbon dioxide adipase from acetate, and then the propionate is converted into a carbon monoxide and lactate and produces ATPs, whereas the butyrate is also in the presence of a acetyl coenzyme butyrate that is converting the butyrate into a carbon monoxide plus ATPs and BHP. This is the pyruvate, the portal flow. The hepatic metabolism takes place in the liver. The liver is taking glucose, the protein, the lactate, and then the butyrate, acetic. And then this protein is goes into the muscle to develop the muscle, and also the glucose and acetate goes into the adipose tissues. The acetate and glucose, lactase and fat is producing the milk. So the volatile, the fat of a volatile fatty acid, that is the producing at the end that muscle, adipose tissues and the milk after digestion and metabolism. The Riemann function overview is that the food is ingested and then taken into the rumen, then the cud is regurgitated, reswallowed, and then it is converted into a crude protein. Then the degraded protein and a microprotein goes into the stomach, and undigestible protein is excreted, whereas the digested the butyric acid, acetic acid, and propionic acid goes to the liver, and it is converted into the glucose energy, and then the excess ammonia also come into the liver where it is metabolized, and then the glucose is given by a liver to the udder to produce the milk, and the acetic acid, butyric acid, and propionic acid is also provided to the udder, and the minerals, the amino acids and fatty acids, vitamins, and water is provided to the udder to produce the milk, and then the indigestible protein is excreted through a anus, and as well as the urea is developed by the liver, it is urinated through a urinary bladder. Now we are discussing a simple stomach. As the simple stomach dog has an esophagus, the simple stomach is a abomasum, which is a one part of or one compartment of the stomach, and this is known as a simple stomach because of a one compartment, and then they have the liver, gallbladder, the stomach having a pylorus and fundus, the body, then the colon, the anus. So we are discussing now the parts of a or anatomy of the stomach. The functional anatomy of the stomach is that it is consists of a fundus, the body, the pylorus, and insectors. So you can see that there are two regions, that is the oral region and caudal region. So caudate region having the part of the body of a stomach, half part of the body of the stomach and a half part of the body is going to the oral region, which has a fundus, and the pylorus and interium is in the caudate region. The histological components of the gastrointestinal tract is that the the outer layer is serosa, and the inner layer is the muscularis, tunica muscularis, which is consists of a longitudinal and circular muscles and mantric plexus, whereas the submucosa having a glandular and basinar plexus, and then the internal layer of the GIT is mucosa. So enteric nervous system is controlling the GIT. Main functions of a stomach is storage of a food, mechanical digestion, chemical and enzymatic digestion. The four phases, that is the digestive process having a four phases, that is the motility, filling, storage, mixing, and emptying. The secretion is a gastric juices, then the digestion, that's a protein partially, and the absorption, lipid soluble substances like alcohol and drugs are absorbed in the in this digestive process. The secretion gastric juices, that are gastric mucosa, the eccentric mucosa lines body and fundus, the pyloric glands area interior, and gastric pits produces the secretions of a gastric juices. Main components of a gastric juices are mucus cells. The mucus cells produce the mucus and bicarbonate, and that is providing a protection, lubrication, and neutralization of the stomach food. The chief cells produce a pepsinogen. When activated, the protein digestion begins, and the parietal cells are oxytic cells, produce the hydrochloric acid, and that is the intrinsic factors activates the pepsinogen, and physical breakdown of a food denature proteins kills the microbial organisms. Intrinsic factors helps in a vitamin B12 absorption. So the nervous system controls the gastric secretions, that is the cephalic phase, that is a tasting, smelling, chewing, swallowing, stimulate the vagus nerve, stimulate the secretion. So the gastric phase, the stomach distension activate the parasympathetic system and stimulate the secretions. Whereas the intestinal phase, the chyme inhibits the parasympathetic, stop the secretions. Whereas the hormonal control of a gastric secretions takes place by the gastrine secreted by the local endocrine cells, activates the gastric secretions under a nervous control. Whereas the secretion of the intrinsic factors, they are secreted by parietal cells, vitamin B12 absorption, important for the RBC formation, deficiency or a failure to utilize the intrinsic factors causes a perinaceous anemia. So you can see that the mechanism of hydrochloric acid secretion, that's the plasma gives the carbon dioxide into the parietal cells. The bicarbonate is, and it mixes, the carbon dioxide mixes with the water. It produces carbonic anhydrases, which generates the carbonic anhydrase, the carbonic acid. That carbonic acid is bifurcated, and then the cleavage of the hydrogen takes place. That produces the bicarbonate, and then it produces the ATPs. The hydrogen is given to the lumen, so that the chlorine is absorbed from a plasma into the parietal cells, and it goes to the lumen. That the hydrogen and the chlorine mixes with each other, that makes the hydrochloric acid in the lumen, which is utilized for the absorption. so that the potassium also provided from the plasma and it enters into the lumen, but came back to the parietal cells and then go out. So therefore, only the hydrochloric acid is utilized in the lumen, which is helpful in the digestion of the carnivores for food items. Thank you very much. This is the last slide where I have concluded all the lectures. Having any question occurred on the basis of this the fermentation of a rumen and the digestion of a simple stomach animals, the similarly the fat and the protein and as well as the carbohydrate is digested in the simple stomach animals as it is described for ruminants. The steps for digestion of a protein and carbohydrates and fats is same as it is described for ruminants. Okay, I'm taking your attendance at this moment, and if anybody has any question about this presentation, I will answer. Okay, so I dismiss the class and you may have to join the other class. Thank you very much.